Homework 6, Section 3.4, Logical Arguments, Video 2. In the previous video, I gave a couple of examples of an argument. One of them was this one. Premise number one, if I stay at home, then I will not catch the coronavirus, COVID-19. Premise number two, I stayed at home. Conclusion, well, I just said if I stay at home, then I will not catch COVID-19. And now I'm telling you I stayed at home. Conclusion, I will not catch COVID-19. But the real question is this conclusion valid? If the first two premises are true, must the conclusion follow? Now, one important thing to mention about arguments is the truth values of the premises is actually irrelevant. We're not asking, is this statement true? Is this statement true? And when they're true, must this follow? We're simply asking, must this conclusion follow from these premises? So in some examples in the homework, you may see some statements, some premises, which are questionable in their truth values, but we're not questioning their truth values. We're simply asking, must the conclusion follow from these premises? But what do I mean by must the conclusion follow? Well, let's start by writing these statements symbolically. And in order to write them symbolically, we need to find our simple statements and represent them with single letters. In the first premise, it's a conditional because of the if-then. So I already know that the first premise is going to be something pointing to something. The first simple statement is between the words if and then. So we're going to define P to be the simple statement, I stay at home. The antecedent, if you will. The second simple statement in the conditional will be the simple statement after the word then. Assuming it's a simple statement, and it is, I will not catch COVID-19. Now, you could argue that that's the negation of a statement because it has the word not in it. However, it is still a simple statement. It conveys one idea, and therefore we can use a single letter to represent it. So we're going to let Q represent the simple statement, I will not catch COVID-19, and that would be the consequent of the first premise, which is a conditional. How would we write the second premise symbolically? Is the second premise even a compound statement? No. It's a simple statement. I stayed at home. And although the verb tenses are different, when you're translating words to symbols, you can be a little bit forgiving of the verb tense. As long as the statements convey the same idea, you can use the same letter. So even though this is stayed and this is stay, I can represent both of them with the letter P. You'll notice that I drew a line between the premises and the conclusion. It's almost as if this is somewhat of a giant addition problem involving words. It's not, but structurally it kind of looks that way. What conclusion are we attempting to draw? Symbolically, I will not catch COVID-19. Well, word for word, that's what we defined as the statement Q. So our premise will be Q. One thing you will notice in a lot of these arguments, in all of them, is that prior to the conclusion, you'll see the three-dot triangle representing the word therefore. In the past, I told you that this is a symbol that basically announces, I'm about to draw a conclusion. Well, that's what I'm literally doing here. And our conclusion, symbolically, is the letter Q. So symbolically, this represents the argument that we're checking for validity. Must statement Q follow logically if these two premises hold? Well, what does that mean, follow logically? Well, let's think about what we're really trying to say, or what we're really trying to answer. What we're asking is, if the first premise holds and the second premise holds, then must the conclusion hold? Let me say that again and listen very closely for some connectives. If the first premise holds and the second premise holds, then must the conclusion hold? Let me write in words what I've just said. A combination of words and symbols. If the first premise holds, so we'll just write premise one, and the second premise holds, then must the conclusion hold? And we're basically asking, is this always true? If the first premise and second premise hold, then the conclusion holds. Must that statement be true? So really what we're asking is this compound statement always true? Wait a minute. A statement that's always true is called a tautology. If the answer is yes, then the argument is valid. The conclusion must follow from the premises. If the answer is no, if it's not a tautology, if this statement is not always true, then the argument is invalid. So it looks like we're right on the precipice of setting up how to analyze the validity of an argument. If we can set up a truth table for the statement I have in quotations here, if we can set up a truth table for that, complete the truth table, and see if it's a tautology, then we'll know whether or not the argument is valid and whether or not the conclusion must follow. In the next video, we're going to do precisely that. We're going to set up this compound statement for this argument, build its truth table, and see if we have a tautology.